Story time on how my high school bully became my stepdaughter. A little backstory, let's call my bully Stephanie. Well, Stephanie loved to bully me in high school. There wasn't a reason other than she just did not like me. And I was very, very innocent, so I let her bully me. She even made up a rumor that I had an STD. That's how bad it was. Well, after high school, I decided to go to college for a year, but then I dropped out. I started working at a law firm, where I met my soon-to-be husband. And of course I didn't know it was her dad. I was working at the law firm only part-time, so I didn't spend much time with him, but we did fall in love really, really quick. We went out on dates first, and he did tell me he had a daughter, but he never showed me a picture of his daughter because he said he didn't have a good relationship with her. Well, for his birthday, we went out to dinner, and he did tell me that his daughter was going to be there. So I wanted to make a good first impression. My high school bully became my stepdaughter. Well, we arrived at the restaurant and she still wasn't there. We knew that she was going to come in a little later. Well, about 30 minutes later, I see Stephanie walking towards me. And I was so confused. I thought she was going to come and say hi to me. And when she saw me next to her father, shit went down. We were at a very fancy restaurant. Well, she asked her father, let's call him Ben, what is she doing here? And he told her to not disrespect me like that because I was his fiance. Mind you, I was laughing because this shit was hilarious. Well, before she stormed out of the restaurant, she told her dad to never talk to her again and said that she would never forgive him. Well, long story short, he did ask me why she said that because he was a little curious of why I was laughing. I explained to him that she was my bully in high school and that she terrorized me for 4 years. And our wedding is in July.
Story time! This is how I got revenge on my sister for sleeping with my husband. If you haven't seen that story time, scroll down and go check it out. So before my ex-husband and I told our family that we were getting a divorce, I decided to throw a little party. Of course, he wasn't invited, but I told my family I had something very important to tell them. This was all the weekend before Easter. Yes, 2021. I told my sister that she had to be there because I had something very, very important to tell all of them. What my ex-husband didn't know is that I went through his phone and I found all her naked pictures. I went online and I bought a projector and I made a little movie with all of her pictures. Also screenshots of our conversation on Bumble. How fun. Well, the weekend came and I was regretting all of it. But as soon as she got to my house, she asked for my ex-husband. And I was like, oh hell no, this is not going to happen. I got drinks for all of my family. My parents were there, cousins, uncles, aunts, just everyone. Follow me for part two. I got revenge on my sister for sleeping with my husband part two. So like I said, I got a projector and I set it up right in the middle of my backyard because I had told everyone that it was movie night. Well, the time comes for movie night. Everyone gets comfortable, everyone has some popcorn, everyone has some drinks. The perfect setup. I named this little movie Our Love Story. As soon as the movie started, everyone was like, aww, but they didn't know that it was gonna take a really dark turn. First slide was how we met on Bumble. Then all the naked pictures of her came up. Everyone was shook, no one moved. Then all her videos came up with my husband, when she was doggy style, missionary, every other position you could think of. Forgot to mention his mom and his sister was there, and my sister's husband. Close to the end of my little movie, everyone got up and was walking away. I told them, no, stay and watch the end. Then the screenshots of the conversation came up, and just one last picture of them together.
Thanks, sis. Story time about the most disgusting night of my life. I was at a bar having a drink by myself. Beside me was a married couple, a female and a male. Let's call them Mark and Sophia. Well, we're having a good time. For about 3 hours, we were having a wonderful conversation. It was time for the bar to close, and the couple asked me to go to their house with them so we can continue our conversation. And I said yes, because I was a little tipsy already. And honestly, I just wanted to keep the party going. Mind you, I'm a man. We got to the couple's house and they start acting very sexual in front of me. They're kissing, hugging, he's kissing her neck. I wasn't really paying attention, I was just drunk and I wanted to continue the party. 10 minutes go by and the guy offers me a glass of whiskey. And of course I take it. 5 minutes after that, he asked me to go to the bedroom. I was hesitating it because I didn't know for what. And honestly, I didn't know this couple, but I ended up saying,
this is how a couple wanted me to do the dirty with a wife while the husband watched. Part 2. Disclaimer, this is not my story.
So they invited me to their bedroom and I ended up saying yes. As soon as I step in the bedroom, I see this whole setup like 50 Shades of Grey type of shit. And there was also a chair, facing right towards the bed. Well, the husband asked me if I ever had a three-way, and I said absolutely not, but that I was very interested. Well, he said that they're not really interested in having a three-way, but that he just wanted to watch me do the dirty with his wife, because that really turned him on. Long story short, I was very, very drunk. I ended up doing it. I didn't sleep over their house because I thought that was very awkward. Ironic, right? But next day, I was so disgusted with myself and that man. Worst part of all of this is that I also got an STD. Follow me and DM me.
I fell in love with my dad's best friend. And here's the story.
My dad is a very well-known businessman, at least in the state that we live in. For personal reasons, I will not be saying which one it is. Well, he's very successful and he has very, very successful friends. For some reason, I've always been attracted to older men. No, I don't have daddy issues. Mom and dad are still together. Well, every month we would have a little business dinner at our house where multiple of his friends would come over and we'd just have a good time. That's where I met, let's call him Philip. I'm 19, by the way. Well, in these dinners, you have to be very, very friendly. Or at least that's what our dad tells us to do. I also have an older brother. Well, Philip would come every month, and we would have a really, really deep conversation. It wasn't in a weird way. I was just trying to be friendly. Well, in December, before Christmas, my parents decide to do this really, really big dinner. They went all out. I'm running out of time. Follow me for part two.
I fell in love with my dad's best friend. Part two. Well, all the guests arrived. I was dressed up really, really nice, waiting for Philip. He arrived a little later, but that was fine. Well, later that night, he decided to tell me that he was in love with me, that all these deep conversations that we've been having, he's never had that connection with anyone, and I said same. Well, we ended up doing the dirty in my parents' bathroom. 2 months after that, we decided to tell my dad. He wasn't really happy about it, but he would always do anything to make me happy. Philip and I have been dating for a while now, and business between him and my dad has never been better.
Story time on how I found my daughter without even looking for her.
When I was 15, I got pregnant by who I thought was the love of my life. But as soon as he found out that I was pregnant, he said he didn't want anything to do about it, and that if I wanted, I could get an abortion. I'm not gonna lie, I was thinking about it. I decided to tell my mom. I was scared at first, but then I remembered my mom and I have a really, really good relationship. And she told me I had three options. I could have the baby, I could have an abortion, or I could have the baby and give it up for adoption. I decided to have the baby, which later on I found out it was a girl, and then give her up for adoption because I wasn't going to be able to give her the life that she deserved. And I said that maybe in the future, I would look for her, explain to her what happened, and tell her that I could be a part of her life if she wanted me to. Well, in 2015, I was able to open my own little coffee shop where I hired three employees. By that time, I was married and had two wonderful toddlers. Well, from the three employees that I hired, one of them was my daughter, but I didn't know it at the time. Running out of time, follow me for part two. I found my daughter that I gave up for adoption without even looking for her. Well, since it was a small business with only three employees and me, I had a close relationship with employees. But I had a close relationship with, let's call her, Julia.
The reason why we had such a close relationship was because she did share with me that she was adopted.
And obviously I shared with her that I did give up a baby for adoption. And she never judged me. She always told me that she would do anything to find her biological mother. This girl was raised right. Well, I shared with her all the details on why I gave my baby up for adoption and that I would love to meet that baby one day. Well, behind my back, she decided to investigate. I don't know how, don't ask me. 3 months later, she came in with some paperwork, told me that she was my daughter, with tears in her eyes. And well, I obviously busted out crying as well. I asked her to forgive me and I told her why it all happened. She told me those weren't sad tears, they were tears of joy. Said she never hated me, and now we're in each other's lives. How crazy.
Story time on how I got revenge on my best friend for sleeping with my boyfriend. So back in June 2019, I was on Tinder, that's where I met my boyfriend. We hit it off right away, and obviously, you know, I shared the details with my best friend, or so I thought she was my best friend. Well, at that time, she was also on Tinder. My best friend is bi, by the way. Well, 3 months into my relationship, I started having a gut feeling about her. Let's call her Sarah. Every time my boyfriend came over, she started acting weird. And when I say weird, I mean she was acting all flirtatious with him. But again, I didn't think anything of it because she's my best friend. Well, one day I invited her for dinner.
And I also invited my boyfriend. By the way, this dinner was at my house. And for that dinner, I wore a dress. Just because it was a special dinner for my friend and my boyfriend. And she wore a cocktail dress. Like a dress that you would wear to a casino. Here's a picture of the dress. Well, I pulled her aside, told her that her dress was extra. Follow me for part two. Getting revenge on my best friend for sleeping with my boyfriend. Well, she said that I was crazy because that was just a normal dress. She told me not to be jealous because I was her best friend. I explained to her that I wasn't jealous, but that I've seen her actions in front of my boyfriend and they're very concerning. Well, whatever. We decided to have dinner. We had a good time. She left and my boyfriend stayed over and I had to work. Well, he was gonna stay over and wait for me to get home from work. The next day, I head off to work. When I got back, I saw my best friend's car outside, ran inside to my apartment, found them hooking up, broke up with him, but here's the good part. I decided to get back at her. I opened up a Tinder as a girl looking for a serious relationship because I know that's what she wanted. I matched with her. We messaged for about 6 months. She was deeply in love with me. She was even talking about moving in together and she didn't even know me in person. We decided to schedule a date where we would move in together. She paid for a deposit and everything for the apartment. Well, that day came. And well, obviously I never showed up. How embarrassing for her.